What's up, Saiyan Army? So just got home from a Vegito workout. That's why the Potara earrings are on fleek. Anyways, what you're watching on your screen is hammer curls. I needed some extra footage, so that is not the exercise I'm gonna talk about. But what I do wanna talk about is my biceps. Now, right now, I'm hitting biceps 3 times a week. So I have 2 moderate volume bicep workouts. That is my pull workouts. So I hit 8 sets on each day. Okay, 1 time a week, I hit heavy biceps. This is my heavy bicep set, I guess 4 sets. Mainly because when you go heavy, especially on arms, I feel like a lot of my joints, I've been lifting for 12 years. So eventually, you know, all that fatigue and all that joint wear and tear is gonna add up. So for me personally, I'm only hitting biceps 1 a week heavy. Now on my 3rd bicep day, that's my shoulders and arms day, which you guys just seen in my last video, that day I hit it for 12 sets. So 2 moderate volume and 1 high volume bicep day. And that's how I will grow my lifetime goal of 18-inch arms. Now thinking back, I was thinking about this earlier, just like 4 or 5 years ago, my arms were 16 and a halfs. So they legit grew about 0.2 inches a year for the past 5 years. So I know these 18s are coming, not anytime soon, but I have the patience, I have the work ethic, and I have the knowledge to go and get that. So they will come eventually. So anyways, this is the exercise I want to show you guys, and that is the incline cable curl. Now, I'm a huge fan of incline dumbbell bicep curls. That's when you put the bench at a 45 degree or maybe even less, and you use that full range of motion. You lean back into it and you curl from that position. The reason why I really like the incline dumbbell curl or even the cable curl that I'm showing you guys now is the range of motion. As you can see, a typical bicep curl, you're gonna come here, come here and curl like that. With the incline, as you lean back, you get a bigger range of motion with your bicep curls. So there's 3 keys as far as form goes to making gain. First key is range of motion. Every single exercise you do should always be full range of motion. Studies show full range of motion grants you greater hypertrophy, even if you have to sacrifice weight for a bigger range of motion. So everything, full range of motion. Second thing is gonna be the weight. The heavier you go, or the stronger you get, the bigger and more hypertrophy will accumulate. The third thing is safety and health and safety. So if your form is on point, you're lifting some heavy ass weight, but you injure yourself, congratulations, you just played yourself, Krillin. So that is the number one way to get kicked out of the hyperbolic time chamber. That is the number one way to stop the gains train from running, and that is to injure yourself. So safety is always first whenever you do any type of exercise. Okay, so make sure that safety comes first, then range of motion, then heavy weight. And just slowly add as you can, don't rush the process. Understand that lifting, we lift for longevity in life. We lift because we love it. We lift to make these gains, and we lift to stay healthy. Okay, so make sure that everything is on point. Anyways, give these incline bicep curls a try. As you can see, I drop the pin all the way down. I lean back and get that full range of motion in my biceps, and I'm feeling that contraction. I'm pulling from my wrist. Okay, that's another big thing. I always see people curling with their flipping forearm. So make sure your wrist stays straight, and you're literally pulling your wrist to your anterior delt. Okay, do not forearm curl these bad boys. Forearms can be worked in other areas. Your forearms are gonna be worked regardless because they're a secondary muscle, but just keep your wrist straight and put all that tension on those biceps. Get that full range of motion, get that stretch, get that squeeze. As you can see, I'm holding at the top for a fraction of a second just to get that full contraction and really feel it. For this exercise, I'm doing 4 sets of 15 reps. No, this is not a primary movement for your biceps. I always recommend, you know, heavy dumbbell hammer curls, heavy dumbbell regular curls, heavy barbell curls. Those are all staple compound movements for your biceps. This is more a secondary accessory type movement. No, this isn't a new movement. This is a movement I used to do a long time ago that I kind of forgot about, that I just started doing again and I really love, which is why I'm sharing it with you guys. So give this video a like if you guys want more quick tip videos, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Much love, strength, and honor. Aloha.
Vegeta, what does the scouter say about his power level?
It's over 9,000! Immortal!